Hi guys. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to create a target bone and also how to stretch the character's body parts. Be sure to subscribe to my channel to see the next videos. As you can see, I have a character that is made up of different layers. I click on the main layer of the character. With the manipulate bones tool, I pull down the bone to which all the parts of the character's body are connected. You can see the character moving down. But when I drag the character down, I want the character's knees to bend and make it look like the character is standing on the ground. First, with the add bone tool, I create two bones at the end of the character's legs. I will name the right bone T2. I will select the bone on the left and name it T1. With the bone strength tool, I set the strength of both bones to 0. With the reparent bone tool, I remove the connection of these two bones to other bones. These two bones should not be connected to other bones. I change the color of these two bones to distinguish them. Now I select these four bones with the select bone tool and click on the bone constraints section. In the maximum stretching section, I determine the amount of bone stretching. The number 1 does not create stretch. The more we increase this number, the more elongation increases. The number 1.2 is suitable for this character. Now I select these two bones and in the bone constraints section, I select the name T1 for target. You can see that a target is created in this section. Now, by moving the T1 bone, the leg of the character is stretched. I select these two bones again and go back to the bone constraints section. I activate the squash and stretch scaling option so that the leg becomes a little narrower during stretching and a more natural shape is created. I write its value as 1.3. The value of maximum and squash and stretch scaling should be almost proportional to each other. Now you can see that the leg becomes a little narrower when stretching. I choose the two bones on the right and I consider the same numbers for these bones. In the target section, I select the T2 option. In this way, stretching is created for both legs of the character. Now, if I pull the waist bone down, the character's knees will bend. In frame 0, this bone does not move. To move this bone, you must place the slider in frame 1 or subsequent frames. By using this simple technique, the character's movements become more natural and you can animate the character more easily. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Until the next tutorial, goodbye for now.